Hello and welcome to another quick Tell Me video on an aspect of reel-to-reel tape recorders, brought to you by Reel Resilience. Owners of reel-to-reel machines often ask me what is causing the tape to catch on the flange of the tape reel as it goes around. Let's see the issue up close in this short video. As you can see, as the reel rotates and the tape is wound in, it catches on the spool flange of each rotation. In some cases, this interference may not be a catch, but the tape is rubbing on the flange. The initial thought may be the flange on the spool is bent, therefore not flat and thus catching as it rotates. This is a possibility with the aluminium spoked reels as they are prone to bending if dropped. The trident type reels are less likely to bend as they are more robust. A simple test is to swap the reels over or use plastic ones to check if the flange is bent. If you find this is the case, then sometimes simple pressure to bend it back may solve the issue. But if you do this, be careful not to bend it too far, as then the flange may be flared out, and if subsequently used with this side facing down to the deck plate of the machine, it will cut a nice circular scratch in the plate, as seen on this Revox B77 front panel. If the problem persists when a number of reels are used, then the issue could be down to misalignment of the spool platter on the motor shaft. Depending on what side of the reel the tape is catching on, the platter could be too high or low relative to the tape guide on the head block. Thus, the tape is not at the ideal angle as it exits or enters the spool and thus catches. In extreme cases, the spool platter may not be sitting on the shaft of the motor correctly and thus wandering up and down as it rotates. This latter issue could be serious as it implies possible wear in the platter, meaning it is not sitting on the shaft correctly, or even bearing wear in the motor causing the shaft to be out of true. To investigate and correct misaligned spool platters, the first thing to do is to get the service manual for your machine and read the section on platter height and its adjustment. Do not attempt to make any adjustments until you have the correct tools and are confident you know what you are trying to achieve. It may require the machine to have its covers removed and powered up, so make sure you take care as there are some high voltages around. Mains voltage aside, many spool motors use 125 volts AC to drive them. Reel Resilience is based in the UK and provides reel-to-reel tape recorder sales, service and repair. On a quarterly basis, we produce a webinar on an aspect of reel-to-reel maintenance and service. Watch out for announcements of these on social media and where you can book your ticket. Around once a month, we produce the Press Play podcast, dedicated to all things tape and tape recorder. Each episode features an interview with a collector, professional user or industry influencer, plus news and tips on the theory of tape recording or machine ownership. You can subscribe via iTunes, Spotify, Google, or wherever you get your podcasts. The last five episodes are also available on the Reel Resilience website, found at www.reelresilience.co.uk, and on the dedicated website, reelresilience.budsprout.com.